Hello and welcome to Sport This Morning. I'm Cecilia Omorogbe.
A very good morning to you. Thanks for joining us as we start another week of sporting action where we take you on a trip across the money-spinning world of sports. I'm Yemi Adebayo. Let's start you off with a big one today. The home Eagles right there in Morocco are ready for action. They will be starting the 2018 African Nations Championship. They're ready for action today and ready to do battle against their opponents,
which is Rwanda, so we can't wait for that to start. Also on the program, we're finally, after 23 games, Manchester City unbeaten run has come to an end, and it was ended at Anfield, courtesy of Liverpool.
Yeah, the Reds rampant in that one, did the job, and ends. The Manchester City's unbeaten streak ends right there at Anfield. All right, let's go talk tennis now. And last year's finalist, Venus Williams, makes an early exit from the Australian Open. She suffered a shock loss, and better luck next time for the experienced player. She lost to Belinda Bencic of Switzerland, and that's how the journey ends before he even started. For Venus Williams.
Overnight shocker, that was what it was on the night. We expected to see Venus Williams also going all the way to the final. Remember last year, she got to the final losing to her sister, Serena Williams. Now, it means the Australian Open on the first day. The two sisters are not here. The first sister, of course, you know what happened. She is not playing. But the one that is playing, well, she's already out. Woke up this morning, like, okay, 7-year-old, she's out of the Australian Open. Now, I think maybe for Venus Williams, could it be the fact that maybe Serena wasn't playing or she just wasn't prepared for the Australian Open?
Well, things like this happen, and I guess maybe because of her age.
You sure about that?
No, that's what I'm saying.
She got to the final, just 1 year difference.
Because of her age, a lot of people will start making conclusions.
Okay, okay.
And it's too early. Even players at the height of their powers, it happens. I mean, Lucas Russell made his name of beating Nadal at one of the tournaments in the first round. So it happens. There's really nothing I could say. Venus, well, we just say better luck next time. That's the only thing I can say. Better luck next time.
I mean, I think it was surprising for was much. Yeah, she was shocked. You know, having played alongside Roger Federer, I'm talking about the mixed doubles in the Hopman Cup.
Yes.
You know, she can actually pick a little bit of things from there. But for Venus Williams, I'm heartbroken this morning that she's out of the Australian Open. Sloane Stephens, I mean, the winner of the U.S. Open. Since that time, she hasn't won, you know, a game. I think maybe she's still trying to enjoy that first Grand Slam.
Maybe.
But this is not an excuse at all. I didn't believe that she would lose to Shang Zhuai, because you have some players that you're starting, you know, a tournament, and you're losing to a player ranked like this that really don't know much about her. You feel, okay, this is really another shocker of the night. 2-6, 7-6, 6-2.
It's surprising because, you know, these are players, the moment they know I'm going to play Sloane Stephens, I'm going to play Venus Williams in first game of the tournament, they're already shivering, they're afraid. Just, I mean, you can see how Bencic celebrated there. I mean, like, of course, it's tough.
Is this really happening?
Did I do this? And of course she did, and that's the way it is. I'm a little disappointed with Sloane. Despite the fact that she won a Grand Slam last year, I expected a lot. You know, she made her name off beating Serena Williams in one of the Grand Slams, and everybody thought she's here. It took her a while. She won a Grand Slam. I thought, okay,
she got injured
now, consistency. But it didn't happen. So we'll see. But I know for the ladies, when it comes to tennis, America is a force to reckon with. And I'm very sure most of these, you know, we've talked about Venus this morning, we've talked about Sloane Stephens. I'm very sure they'll bounce back.
Okay, but two Americans are out. That's the upset of the night. Another upset of the night. Before we get to the other upset of the night, talked about Schiavone, talking about Yelena Ostapenko. We're looking forward to another upset of the night. But then she knew what she needed to do. Of course, she was able to, you know, take out Schiavone. Schiavone actually won the French Open in 2010, but then she threatened to take over Ostapenko in that game, but it was Ostapenko who had the better one, and she won that game, just easing through in a very, will you say, spectacular manner, 6-1, 6-4. So for Francesca Schiavone, she is out, but Ostapenko, Yelena Ostapenko, she continues to see if she can add the Australian Open to the one she won before. This one was quite sweet, easy, no much drama.
Yeah, judging by the scoreline anyway, I saw some of the highlights, and I think she did well. A little bit of a scare in the second set, but you know, nice one. And of course, you were talking about the big one.
Yeah.
I mean, shocking. 11th seed, South Africa's Kevin Anderson, big hitting Kevin Anderson, and shock loss to Kyle Edmund.
Edmund, yeah.
I didn't see
five set thriller. I didn't see it coming at all. I felt Kevin Anderson, when you push him like that, somehow he's got a way of bouncing back, but that just didn't happen. So he's out of it. 6-7 after winning that first set, but somehow 6-7, 6-3, 3-6, 6-3, 6-4. That's how it ended. He won just two sets in that one, where Edmund wanted it more on the night, and he won. So he's out. Other results that we'll be taking a look at this morning. Not much of the upset, but then you have some other big boys winning. Grigor Dimitrov winning, Shapovalov winning, and all these guys just taking it cool and winning their game this morning.
And a few minutes from now, we expect Rafael Nadal to be in action against Victor Estrella. With respect to him. Nick Kyrgios as well against Rogerio Dottor Silva. Nick Kyrgios has told us, I mean, I'm still going to be the Nick that you know. Don't think that my conduct will change. I'm still... But the home fans will be behind him. We'll see what happens.
Yeah.
He didn't get any violations, throughout the Brisbane International. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are hoping they're going to see that type of chaos. Who's not going to slam the racket? Who's not going to make any rants? So we'll see what happens as the days goes by. And... Samantha Stosur will be in action today, and Caroline Wozniacki as well will be in action. So we'll see where it goes from there. All right, let's quickly give you an update. You know, here at China's television, news comes first. Let's continue with that breaking story that we gave you earlier. It says that the death toll in the Lagos gas station fire is said to have risen to 10. Several other persons are